Imagine growing up, knowing you're a little different to your peers, but you're not sure why. You struggle to be understood at school. Academically, I knew things, but I didn't show my true potential. The playground is such a confusing place. Why don't they just say what they mean and follow the rules? The uniform day in, day out was great, but the skirt seams, ugh, is there even a word for that? When I arrive home from my school, my mind is exhausted from trying to do the right thing, say the right thing, and understand the world around me. All of my senses are on high alert. I just want to be in my own world, but my iPad is flat. I drop to the floor, crying in front of my mum, drowning the outside world with my voice, hands over ears, unable to use the words to describe how I'm feeling right now. Welcome to the wonderful world of autism, where the challenges faced in the classroom by autistic girls often overshadow their strengths and capabilities. One reason offered for the imbalance of studies on autistic girls compared to their male counterparts is due to fewer girls being diagnosed than boys, and their presentations may also differ. The lack of knowledge and understanding for autistic girls in the school context is one reason girls are missing out on vital supports in their education. This in turn means teachers may be underprepared to teach autistic girls. My research explored the learning experiences of Alana and Bree, who are on the autism spectrum and in their first year of formal schooling, so aged 6 and 7 respectively. Through observations and interviews with their mothers and teachers, I developed theory and knowledge around autistic girls' varied behaviours and characteristics and how they can be best supported in the classroom. Key ideas emerged and were categorised onto 6 themes: communication, academic, social, sensory, identity, and encircle. Encircle encompassed 4 further areas: challenges, intervention, professional development, and classroom strategies, which were largely derived from the teacher interviews. Where there are pictures on the Cassie wheel, there is usually a set of characteristics, with a number of them shared in my earlier story. There is overlap of some of these characteristics between themes, with the most relevant theme allocated. The development of the Cassie tool was the principal outcome to facilitate change in the classroom by providing a resource for teachers to better understand the varied characteristics of girls on the autism spectrum and provide strategies that will assist them reach their potential. The implementation of the Cassie tool will benefit not only teachers and autistic girls themselves, but also their parents and their wider support network of girls who are on the autism spectrum, even if not yet diagnosed. The Cassie tool will help ensure autistic girls and their learning needs are no longer invisible.